Jimi Hendrix is considered one of the greatest guitarists in rock and roll history. He was from Seattle, but before Hendrix became famous in the U.S. in the late 1960s, he had a following in London. Now that city has turned his last residence there into a museum. The NewsHour's Phil Hirschkorn has more.
Before releasing his third and final studio album, Jimi Hendrix was living in London, playing venues like Royal Albert Hall. In the summer of 1968, Hendrix rented a top-floor apartment in this building. Girlfriend Kathy Etchingham moved in with him.
Well, it's quite strange, as you can imagine, 45 years on, to be sitting in the same room you were sitting in when you were 22 years old.
The apartment is now restored as it looked then. Colorful cushions, Persian rugs, a Victorian shawl hanging over the bed. There's Hendrix's turntable and vinyl record collection. He wrote songs on an Epiphone acoustic guitar. Etchingham says Hendrix told her this was his first real home of his own. The building in London's Mayfair neighborhood had good musical karma. Classical composer George Friedrich Handel lived next door in the 1700s. Magazine photographer Barry Wenzel visited Hendrix in this apartment.
He said, yeah, I went out and got the Handel's Messiah the other day. And, oh man, that'd be really interesting. I wonder it'd be like to jam with him, you know.
Hendrix moved back to New York in 1969 and returned to England for concerts. He died in London in 1970 at age 27. The Handel House Trust spent $3.5 million renovating the apartment and is making Handel and Hendrix in London open to the public permanently.